I'm in the Tesla Model Y, and in the latest over-the-air updates, which was 2024.26.3.1, they introduced scheduling for both preconditioning and charging. So in this video, I'm just going to go through that and show you how it works, because it's a welcome change in the Tesla. So in the menu, there is now a new sub-menu called Schedule, and this has been implemented really well. It's very easy to use. So you can create a schedule based on the location. So I've got home and work here, and if I had more favorite locations in the sat nav, then they would be more listed there, and I can create a location as well. And then your schedules are set per that location, so you can have different schedules depending on different locations, which is great. So let's cover the charging first, because that's the one that most people are going to use primarily. 90% of the viewers of this channel are not subscribed. I'm sorry to ask, but it would help greatly if you would. Just press the subscribe button. It's free and it shows YouTube you like this sort of vehicle-related content. If you want to be notified when new videos are released, please click on the bell button also. Thank you, it really helps more than you would imagine. So, what you can now do is create a very simple start and end schedule. So this is what all EVs pretty much do. Tesla implemented it a very awkward way before and didn't have stop times. So now they've introduced the stop times, it is much easier. So let's create a schedule. So typically, I would imagine most people are going to be on the Octopus Intelligent Go tariff. So I'll set it for 11:30 p.m. and end at 5:30. And that wants to be, I was right, that wants to be PM ending in AM, and I'm going to set it for every day of the week and repeat every week. And it's as simple as that. So we've now got our schedule created. And then you might want to precondition your car. So let's say you're going to leave to go to work at 8 AM in the morning, and you just want that to be on every weekday. You would set that up like that. And that's the typical scenario that most people are going to want to set their electric car up for. So it's going to charge every night on cheap rate electricity and then precondition their car in the morning for when they've got to go to work. And that will be heating it in the winter, and in the summer it will be cooling it. But you can create multiple schedules. So if you wanted a different one at the weekends, we can create another one there. So as to the maximum number of schedules you can create, I don't know. I've created 11 here and I can still add more. So I don't know what the maximum is, but that's going to be more than enough. Even if you're on the Octopus Agile tariff and you've got 30 minute billing, which I'm on, I'm never going to need that many schedules. So Tesla have implemented this really quite well. It's just simple and easy to use. And because they've got locations and you can have different schedules based on your location, it's actually very comprehensive, and it will be ideal for people that charge at home or charge at work or have got multiple premises that they might charge their vehicle at. And let's just have a look at how this looks in the app. So we've got our schedule here, and then we've got all the information that I had there on the screen, and we can then press the plus at the top to create a new schedule. So it all looks very similar as it does on the screen in the car. And that's all pretty easy, isn't it? So finally, I'll just cover editing a schedule or deleting it. So if I click on one, it then comes back to the original create screen, where you can then edit it and save it, or we can just delete it. So it's all very simple. There's also a quicker way to delete a schedule if you want to, by hitting the X on the right hand side there. This is a one click process, so it's a shame they don't bring up a box to say, are you sure? Because that could be a bit too easy to delete your schedule. But anyway, it's very simple to recreate one. So I'll keep this video short. If you found it useful, please do click the thumbs up. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. If you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y, in the video description below is a playlist where you can see those other videos. Hookadook, I'll see you on the next one.